Hey guys, welcome to the channel. My name is Maritza. Today, you will learn how to create a children's activity book using an activity book generator that I just discovered. We will also be using Canva because I want to show you how you can create your activity pages along with your book front cover and back cover all in the same document. Let's get started. What you're currently looking at right now is the activity book generator, and this is the dashboard. And I, as you can see, the membership level is main. I do not have the pro members software. I just got the main because I wanted to see what this was all about. I wanted to test it out, see how more efficient I could be when I'm creating book covers, whether it's for my clients over on Fiverr and Upwork, or if it's just for books that I want to create for my kids or for to sell on Amazon KDP. So now I'm going to go click on main members. Okay. And then here, this is extremely cool. I found this extremely cool. There is the random generator, and then I saw the My Project Manager. These are two different things. And what it says random generator, what it basically means is that it will create certain pages randomly, like the software that I used on the one of the videos that I did. I'm going to put it up on top. The video with the puzzle generator that I use, that was like AI powered. Well, this is similar to that. I found another one. I want to say a few months ago, and I thought it was like a waste of time. It didn't have this random generator where it creates it in like seconds, like the activities. So let me go ahead and click on for the kids activities under kids. It says activities and coloring. I want to choose the letter page size, which is, I believe it's 8.5 by 11. So let me go ahead and choose coloring. I'm going to click on that. And right here, it's leading us to what it's basically going to do, this AI. It's going to create, when you select the number of pages, coloring pages that you want, the max is 30. But you can do this multiple times so that you can, I guess, at the end have like a 100 page coloring book, kids coloring book, right? So I'm going to just go ahead and click on 10. And then once I click on create, I believe it takes a couple seconds. Let me see. Okay, there it is. So let me open this file and we're going to take a look at this and see what the generator came up with. And these are some of the coloring pages. Now you may be thinking, when I saw this, I was like, wow, this is very basic, but that's exactly what's cool about it, because you can go ahead and customize it and make it your own. And it just makes it so much faster to work with instead of picking out, you know, trying to do this one page at a time. But let me go ahead and go back to the main members area. And I'm going to go down where it says to my project, and it says click to access your project manager. Okay, when it comes to the project manager here, you will see that there are many different activity pages. And I saw on the dashboard, there was like an announcement from this company, and the owner of this generator is that they add, I believe, a few pages, or I think it's like one page every single Monday of each week. So there are always, I guess, a gallery of images to choose from, and it's always increasing, which is a good thing. Now, I mean, there are so many pages here. I can't go through all of them in the video, but if you do decide to go ahead and get this generator, go ahead and play around with it. I'm going to go ahead and put the link down below. And there are tons of images that you can use. Maybe we're in the summertime, so maybe like a summer activity book for children would be great. Let me see what else. These are snowflakes. And I mean, just there are so many different icons. But now what I want to show you is how you can the pages that the generator just generated for me for this coloring book. We're going to go ahead and upload this onto Canva because I want to show you something. Let's head on over to Canva. I'm going to click on upload here to the right hand side, and we're going to upload those coloring pages. I'm going to choose the first one that's there. It's going to upload it onto Canva, and we can use it. And I've been playing around with this generator just to see what it comes up with. Okay, so there is the document. Okay, great. Now, as you can see, which is pretty cool, is that these images, you can minimize it or maximize it. And you can even duplicate it, maybe flip it, and create maybe small ones and just different sizes. Let's see. And this could be one coloring page. Because I know a lot of you might be thinking like me, what if I use this generator and all these other people are using this generator, and what if we all have the same pages? Well, the cool thing about that and what the cool thing about the generator is that it generates images at random. So that's always good. But even then, you can always grab the document, upload it on Canva, and then just customize it and make it your own. We can add some words here. We can do different things. Okay, so this is a whale. Now, what we can do here is we can go on to elements and we can write the word whale. Okay, and then whale and white. Okay, and then we can add maybe a page with different whales. And then let's see, let's remove this one. So maybe we can add two, this one and this one. I hope that's a whale. It looks like a whale to me. Okay. So we can do something like that. And we can add words on top of this page if we want to. So we make it completely, it's basically, now it's just a new drawing. It's a new coloring page that is unique. I don't know. Let's see. Let's put this here. And then let me drop this down a little bit more. And boom, you have a brand new coloring page. And you can just continue to do this over and over again. And then until you feel that you have created something that's unique. Now, I'm going to go back to the generator because I wanted to show you these pages on the side. Let's say that you want to do some of these. I'll show you now. Let me go back. There are these pages that are like landscape, as you can see here to the right. Let me just go ahead. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me just remove some of these. I don't want to use too many for this example. Let's see. That maze is fine. And then let me just use 2 of these. Oh, that's fine. So what I'm going to do is these 3 pages, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, I'm going to save this. I'm going to title it Activity Pages. Okay, wait, let me go ahead. You know what? Let me go ahead and add. I kind of like these robots. Let me add a robot. Now let me save it. Okay, I'm going to save it. I'm going to save this. And then I'm going to click on compile. You're working. Your PDF will be available for download in just a few minutes. And then I'm going to give it a second. And then it'll allow me to, it says working. Okay, perfect. So let me scroll up and it says you have a PDF available. So I'm going to click there. And okay, great. So let me click on that PDF and we have our pages here. Now we can incorporate these pages onto the ones we already have on Canva. So we're going to go ahead and include those pages that just populated, these activity pages. We're going to incorporate it to our book. How can we do that? Let's upload it. Got to go back to home because it's there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start saving these. This I need to minimize. I'm going to start saving these as PNG files, one by one. Okay, now that we're back to the first document that we were creating, I'm going to go ahead and upload, click on upload. I'm going to add some pages. I'm going to add this page here. And I'm going to add the robot. I can expand it a little bit. Perfect. And then I'm going to add a page after the whale. And I'm going to add the other activity page to it. Perfect. Okay. Now we have an activity page. We have 12 pages. That was very simple. It was very easy. And now all that we have left to do, and remember, this is very basic. I mean, this is just a little tutorial where I'm just showing you how it works. Now I'm going to go ahead and add 2 pages to the front. This is what I always do when I'm working on my own projects, or I'm working on activity books or any other type of book for my clients. So now on the first and second page of this document, let me just go ahead and click on the grid view. Okay, so these are our activity pages. Okay, and then the first and the second page, I always reserve for the front and back cover. Okay, so let me go ahead and click on the first one, and we can start working on our front cover for this activity book. We can use the images that we already have here, okay, on our book for the front cover, if you'd like. If not, not a problem. If you don't know what to do, how to design this, that's okay. We're going to head on over to Amazon. Now that we're here on Amazon, we're going to start searching for coloring books for kids ages 4 and 8. That's totally fine. And then we're just going to take a look at what type of covers we have here. In today's world, there are plenty of AI softwares that you can use to create an amazing and epic book cover for a coloring book. However, for the sake of this example, if you do not want to do that and you don't want to hire anyone on Fiverr or Upwork to go ahead and do the design, that's not a problem. We can do that here. All you have to do is go on and study the book covers that are already on the market. Something like this is extremely simple. Something like this one where it says 50 animals, coloring book, and fun facts. You can recreate this and think about other shapes too. For example, you see how there's a circle right here on the, let me just go ahead and click on that so we can see it. There's a circle in the middle of the page, and then you have the ages for kids 4+. This is very simple and it's something that you can recreate. And it doesn't even have to be a circle. It could be something different. Let me go ahead and go back to the Canva document that we're working on. This is page 1. And we're going to start recreating a book cover. Let me go ahead and let's look at shapes. Shapes. Let's go ahead and just add the heading. Okay, so something like this will do. Let me go ahead and add some more elements like flowers. So your back cover can be something very simple, and we can look at other examples that we see on Amazon. And as you can see, the back cover here shows just 4 images of what you can expect to find in the activity book. So all we have to do is we're going to go here and we can save some of these pages. Well, we already have some, so let me go ahead and add those to this page number 2. Okay, great. So now that we have these 2 pages, we can work with this and then maybe add a solid color to this background. We can do a green. And then we're going to edit the image by adding a shadow effect. like a glow or something like this. I prefer that one. Let me go ahead. So we can do something like this. And then something like that. What we can do here is we can add some content. Let me just duplicate this since we already have that font there. And we can do fun summer activities for children. Can't type today. For children, we can put it on the side or something like that, or we can just bring this down and put it toward the middle. And it's just, there you go. Fun summer activities for children. And then we can do something. I'm going to do this again in the bottom, just minimize it a little bit. Screen free activities for screen free activities that make learning fun. There you go. I'm gonna put that, add this color, and you could add other elements from here that you used here, such as these flowers. Then you could do something like this maybe, and then something like this. Let me flip it and see what's that.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'm going to go ahead and continue to explore other options of what this activity generator can do. I was interested in seeing the Sudoku for the just how it creates them at random. And I was actually taking a look at this earlier today, and it actually provides the puzzles along with the solutions right on the same document, which I thought was really cool. If you guys are interested, I can create a video on how to create those pages on a Sudoku or other types of puzzle books and mazes and all that good stuff. And well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you on the next one.